Good morning, children. Welcome to our history class. Last day we were discussing about the fourth chapter history, in that we are discussing important points, that is about the rulers, different Mughal rulers. Okay, so about the Mughal Emperors, and in that we were discussing the important Mughal rulers and how they succeeded their powers, and all these things we were discussing. And today I am going to explain about the Mughal tradition of succession and the Mughal relationship with the other rulers and the administrative system of Mughals, that is Mansubas and Jagirdar system and other systems. We can discuss through this video. Okay, so you can go through our class. Before that, you have to take your textbook and open it and take page number 50 and watch this video carefully. Minimum 3 times you have to watch it and understand it. After that, you have to underline important points in your textbook. Okay, which I am discussing, all these points you have to underline in your textbook. After that, you can do your works. Because this much works in this section you have to do. You have to watch minimum 3 times this video. After that, you have to read the textbook and underline important points which where I discuss. And after that, you can do your activities and send it to all of you. How to do all these things and do it very well. Okay. Okay, so we can go to our class. Okay, children. Mughal traditions of succession. That means the Mughal did not believe in the roles of primogeniture, where the eldest son inherits his father's estate. So that is Mughal tradition of succession means how Mughals succeeded, Mughal rulers succeeded their power after emperor, how they are other emperor, how they are taking charges. Okay, so the Mughal did not believe the roles of primogeniture, where the eldest son inherited his father's estate. So primogeniture powers means we studied in Delhi Sultanates, they are the eldest son. After the father's time, the eldest son is taking the next ruler. Okay, so that is the primogeniture, where the eldest son inherited his father's estate. So this Mughal did not believe this primogeniture system. Okay, and instead they followed the Mughal and Timur customs, coppersonary inheritance. What do you mean by coppersonary inheritance? That means coppersonary refers to the equal inheritance. Equal, so that means how many children are there, equal powers divided into equal, they have the who are the powerful, they can become the ruler. Okay, so that is coppersonary inheritance, equal inheritance. Okay, or a division of the inheritance among all the sons. That means follow the when you are discussing the tables, when we are discussing the studying about the rulers, we studied that many rulers, these brothers attacked, and at last who won, they are getting the power. Okay, so that means they have the equal chance to get equal power, rights to get the power. But what they have to do, who are the powerful person, they have to fight, and after that they are getting. So these brothers, they are not primogeniture, they are not following the primogeniture system. Instead that coppersonary system they are following, in that equal sharing is happening. So equal rights is there for becoming a ruler. Then who are the powerful in that amongst the daughters, who are sons, who are the powerful rulers, man become the ruler. Okay, that is known as coppersonary. In that Akbar's history, Aurangzeb's history, and all other Jahangir's history, we can, if you read that one more time, you can understand that the fight between brothers, it is happening. How, why it is happening? They are not believing primogeniture system, they are believing coppersonary, they have the equal rights to get the power. Then who are the powerful man in that among them, they become they defeated and they become the ruler. Okay, like that the system is going, that is known as coppersonary. Okay, then Mughal relationship with the other rulers. Okay, so always Mughals deals with the other rulers in a friendship systems they are following. The Mughal rulers campaigned constantly. A great rulers were refused to accept their authority, but the Mughals become powerful. Many of the rulers joined them voluntarily. The Rajputs are example of this. Many of them married the daughters of the Mughal families and received high positions. Many resisted as well. So you look at the Mughal tradition is that after defeating an area and when they are becoming under the control of Mughals that time, and after that they are respecting that regions and that rulers, and like that a friendship move they are going. Okay, so when you studied in Akbar's when we were discussing about history of Akbar, we were discussing about Akbar policy. Akbar was a compassionate ruler. Even after defeating the Rajput kings, he did not insult or humiliate them. So that is a policy of the Mughal rulers. It's also followed other rulers also. Most of the rulers are following like this system. When they are defeating one area, and after that they are capturing, and after that they are not insulting that people and not humiliating them, and with respect they are treating, and their dignity is not violated. So like that they are. So that is why Rajputs, when after the defeating the Rajputs, what they were the great warriors. So that what happened, these Mughals gave respect to them and appointed in that regions important positions, gave back the important positions. Okay, so like that it was going on. Okay, so he found the Rajput warriors were brave and loyal. He allowed the Rajput rulers to rule over their territories even after they were defeated in war. So after defeating the war, these Mughal rulers, they are give back their territories and allowed to rule them. Under the control of Mughals, they are allowed to rule. So with respect and dignity is given to them like that. So that is a good policy of the Mughals. So the much problem will not be there. After defeating one area, that people were allowed to rule there. So under the control of Mughal rulers. So Mughals, for the administration, they did not make any problem. So that is the importance of the Mughals. Okay, so that is the Sisodia Rajput of Mewar refused to accept Mughal authority of the long time. Once defeated, however, they were honorably treated by the Mughals, given their lands as a Vathan back as assignment. The careful balance between defeating but not humiliating their opponents enabled the Mughals to extend their influence over many kings and chieftains. But some of the rulers did not follow this one. That is example of Aurangzeb after defeating Shivaji. In the Maratha, Shivaji, he insulted Shivaji. Okay, that make many consequences in the Aurangzeb's period. Okay, so the most of the rulers are expected when they defeated other areas and other rulers, after that they are giving back that their land as assignments, and that like they are carefully balanced between defeating but not humiliating their opponents enabled the Mughals to extend their influence over many kings and chieftains. So like that the system was going on. Okay, then the Mughals Mansabdari system, the administrative system of the Mughals. The word Mansab means a position of a rank. A Mansabdar was a person who hold a Mansab. Okay, who is holding a rank, that person is known as Mansabdars. Okay, as the empire expanded, the encompassed different regions, the Mughals recruited diverse bodies of people. From a small nucleus of Turkish nobles, they expanded that, including Iranians, Indians and Muslims and Afghans and Rajputs and Marathas and other groups. So when they are expanded their territories, they selected different nobles from the noble families, noble people or noble rulers from these areas for the administrative offices. Okay, so they were selected from the Muslims, Afghans, Rajputs, Indians, Marathas, and from this group, those who joined Mughal service were enrolled as Mansabdars. Okay, So those who joined the Mughal services, they were known as Mansabdars. Okay. The term Mansabdars refers to the individual who hold a Mansab, meaning a position of rank. Okay. If who are holding in the Mughals, under the control of Mughals, the Mughals dynasty, who are holding the rank or a position, that person is known as Mansabdars. Okay. Who are holding the power, that person is known as Mansabdars. Okay. So the word Mansab means a position of rank. Then Mansabdva means what? Who are holding a Mansab, who are holding a position, that person is known as, was known as Mansabdars. Okay. So Akbar organized his nobility and the army into the Mansabdari system. This system was not a hereditary. Okay. When a Mansabdar died, his jagir was given away to someone else. Under this system, grading was used by the Mughals to fix the ranks. Okay. So according to the ranks system, this is a Mansabdari system, the ranking system. Who is holding the rank or position, that person is known as Mansabdars. And Mansab means a rank. Okay. So who is holding this ranks or position, that person is known as Mansabdars. So it was a grading system used by the Mughals to fix rank, salary and military responsibilities. Okay. So about this Mansabdari system, I will take in another class. This much you have to read and study. Okay.